हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम बैक टू रिलीफ ट्यूटोरियल्स। इन द प्रीवियस सेशन वी हैव डिस्कस अबाउट व्हाट इज फाइबर एंड आल्सो द टाइप्स ऑफ फाइबर। वी हैव सीन दैट देयर आर टू मेन टाइप्स ऑफ फाइबर्स, नेचुरल फाइबर्स एंड ह्यूमन मेड और आल्सो कॉल्ड एज सिंथेटिक फाइबर्स। वी हैव आल्सो सीन अबाउट व्हाट इज पॉलीमर, मोनोमर, polymerization reaction, and also we have studied about two types of synthetic fibers called rayon and nylon. We have seen their characteristics and their uses. Now the third type of synthetic fiber is polyester. Full form of polyester is polymer of ester. Ester is nothing but the one type of monomer. So you can imagine polyester structure like this. One of the ester molecule combined with another ester molecule, and such number of ester molecules combine, and such type of polymer is called as polymer of ester compounds, and this polymer of ester is known as polyester. Esters are actually petrochemicals, the chemicals obtained from petroleum, and they possess fruity smell. They possess fruity smell. Some examples of polyester fibers are pterylene, pteren, dacron. These are some polyester fibers. Also terricot. Terricot is obtained by blending pterylene with cotton. The name itself suggests you. So if someone asks you what is terricot, so it is the fiber made from pterylene and cotton. Same way we have terry-wool. Terry-wool means pterylene plus wool. Okay. Some properties of polyester fiber. It is most of properties are as common as nylon. It is lightweight. Nylon is also lightweight, strong, elastic. Nylon is totally water resistant. Nylon does not absorb water, whereas polyester absorbs little amount of water when it came into contact with water. Little amount of water is actually absorbed by polyester, but it dries quickly. Cotton, wool, silk are the natural fibers which absorb high amount of water, and they do not dry quickly. But this polyester absorbs little amount of water and dries quickly. It is also wrinkle free means it is not crumpled into creases, just like cotton, silk, wool are not wrinkle free. They need regular ironing But polyester is wrinkle free. What are the uses of polyester? It is used to make saris, curtains, and dress material. Second use, they are used to make sails of sailboat. Okay, sails of sailboat is formed from polyester. Water hoses. I think you have seen the in the fire safety equipments, there is a hose pipe. Hose pipe, the firefighters use one particular type of pipes to throw water on the burning substance. So that water hose or the hose pipe are made from polyester. Because it absorbs very little amount of water, so it will have a layer of water over the hose pipe, so it will not catch fire. So water hoses in the hose pipes which are used, water hoses used for fire fighting operation. Fourth use, they are used to form conveyor belts. In many machineries, I think you have seen that two pulleys are moving and there is a belt joining with each other. So if one of the pulley is rotating, with the help of conveyor belt, this belt, second pulley is also keep rotating. So these conveyor belt are usually made from polyester fibers. As we have seen, terricot, which is made from terrylene and cotton, this is the blended fiber with the help of which we can obtain fabrics and stitch clothes, means terricot shirts, trousers, dress material is formed from terricot. So in place of cotton, we usually wear terricot. Terry wool. Obviously, it is having a wool blended with terrylene. So it is used to form jackets, suits, etc. So these are some common 5 uses. 6 and the most important use to be remembered. It is a mixture of plastic as well as this polyester fibers. PET. P means polythene. Terephthalate. PET, polythene terephthalate. Full form of PET is polyethylene terephthalate. This is the form of mixture of polyester and particular type of plastic. This type of mixture is normally used to form bottles
cold drink bottles.
We are very well aware of these cold drink bottles. Thumbs up, Pepsi, Coca-Cola. Such type of cold drinks are sell in this type of bottles. Even we use bottles to carry water to school, to keep in the fridge. So those bottles are also made from PET. Remember, it's a mixture of one particular type of plastic as well as this polyester fiber. Even in industries, industrial use, even in industries, PET is used to sell oils. Oil is filled in these type of bottles, and in industries they sell oils in such type of bottles. Other uses of PET is what household utensils can be formed made up of such type of plastic and polyester fiber PET. Wires can be formed. I think you have seen the films which we use to make a layer on the glass of our cars. The black colored film, sometimes the blue colored film is used, even white colored film. Film means thin layer which is sticked on the glass of our cars. So these are the uses of polyester fiber. The last type of fiber to be studied is acrylic fiber. Acrylic fiber is made from monomer. Polyacrylonitrile. This monomer, in short, is written as PAN. PAN. Polyacrylonitrile. Consider this is one of the polyacrylonitrile monomer connected to another polyacrylonitrile. So such type of n numbers or infinite numbers of PAN molecules combined together, they form polymer of polyacrylonitrile, and that is called as acrylic fiber. So it is always important to remember that each fiber is made from which monomer, because each fiber is one type of polymer. So obviously they are made up of some and some type of monomer. Okay, just like the rayon is made from cellulose monomer, nylon is the polymer of amide monomer, polyester is the polymer of ester monomer, and acrylic fibers are the polymer made from polyacrylonitrile monomer. This PAN is normally obtained again from petroleum. So most of the synthetic fibers like nylon, polyester, acrylic fibers are made from the petroleum products. So they are totally synthetic. But as we discussed earlier, rayon is actually made from cellulose, and cellulose is a natural material. So rayon is synthetic. Also we can say regenerated fiber. We have discussed this. What are the characteristics of acrylic fiber? Again, it is lightweight. Again, it is soft. The most important characteristics of acrylic fiber that it is warm and it gives wool-like finishing and wool-like feeling. So, it is used to replace wool because the natural original wool obtained from the sheep, the original wool is quite expensive. Whereas acrylic fibers are much cheaper. So we have uses, and in that the first use, that original wool is quite expensive. So what we use acrylic fibers to replace wool fabrics or wool clothes. So it is used to make sweaters, jackets, shawls. All these are the clothes which we use to get warm feeling. So in short, acrylic fibers resembles wool. Just like the rayon is artificial silk, we say. It resembles silk. It is replacing silk because the original silk obtained from the silk worms are quite expensive. Same way, acrylic fibers resembles wool. So they are used to form sweaters, jackets, shawls, cushions, etc. So, small topic of acrylic fibers. The monomer used in acrylic fibers is polyacrylonitrile, PAN. Lightweight, soft material, gives warm feeling like wool. So, now in your textbook, the topic is about advantages of synthetic fibers over natural fibers. The first advantage which is not given in your textbook is that synthetic fibers are much cheaper as compared to the natural fibers. So that is why the use of this type of fibers are promoted. The first use, according to your textbook we are going, the first advantage is that synthetic fibers has very high tensile strength. Tensile strength means they can be stretched. Without breaking. To understand this, one of the activity is given in your textbook. Let us see the figure from your textbook. That here is one of the stand. Iron stand is here. One of the thread is taken. Let us say we are taking four different types of threads. Silk, cotton, wool, which are the natural fibers. Let us take one of the artificial fiber as nylon. Having the equal length, it is here in activity is given that you have to take 30 cm long thread of equal thickness, equal length, equal thickness. Consider you are taking cotton thread first. One of the pan is suspended. Now you are placing marbles one by one. There is a cotton thread is taken in the first observation. You are placing one marble. I think this cotton thread will be stretched because of the weight. Second marble, more stretching is occurring, but still the thread is not broken. Third marble, fourth marble. You keep putting marbles until the thread breaks. Okay, so repeat this activity by taking what? Wool. fiber, silk fiber, and the nylon fiber. So you will observe that nylon fiber bears maximum weight. Maximum marbles will be placed in the case of nylon, and it may be observed that nylon thread is not broken. Wool, silk, cotton will be broken after placing some number of marbles depending on their strength, but nylon will not be broken, maybe, or it may be broken by placing the number of marbles. So it has a strong tendency. So finally, the conclusion is that artificial or the synthetic fibers has a high tensile strength. They can be stretched without breaking, means they can bear more weight. They can bear more weight as compared to the natural fibers. Nylon having the highest tensile strength as compared to silk, then cotton, and then wool. So this is the order of tensile strength. Nylon having highest tensile strength as compared to silk. Silk is having somewhat more tensile strength as compared to cotton, and wool is very less tensile strength possessing. So first advantage over the natural fiber is high tensile strength. Second advantage is low water absorption. So when we put two fabrics, let us say one of nylon and another of cotton, in water, so cotton will absorb more water and nylon is almost water resistant. If you place polyester, so it will absorb little amount of water. So if you take, see, activity given in your textbook is like this, that consider this is the two mugs of water. Initially both possess equal amount of water. And now place one of the nylon cloth here and the cotton cloth here in this. When you take it out, you will observe that the most of means lot of amount of water is absorbed and less water left in the mug. Here almost no water is absorbed. And if some water is absorbed, when you keep them for drying, nylon will be dries faster. Takes less time to dry, and cotton takes much longer time to dry. So it is one of the important advantage that it is having, means synthetic fibers having low water absorption property. So they absorb very less amount of water as compared to natural fibers. And if some amount of water is absorbed, they can be dried faster. That is why they possess drip dry characteristics. Drip dry means what? That water, if some amount of water is absorbed in synthetic fibers, they can be easily dried within a short interval of time. This characteristic is called as drip dry characteristics. Third advantage, that synthetic fiber possess good elasticity. Elasticity means the property to regain their original shape and size on removal of force. We know, I think, elastic rubber, that if you stretch it, when you apply force, it can be stretched, but when you remove force, it goes back to the original shape and size. So most of the natural fibers do not possess that much amount of elasticity. If you try to stretch them, it will be broken. But nylon, polyester, and other synthetic fibers possess good elasticity. Okay. Fourth advantage is very common, which we have discussed also, that synthetic fibers are wrinkle free. they cannot be crumpled and may and forms many creases. Just like cotton, if you crumple them, it forms many creases. Like for example, let us say this is one of the handkerchief made up of cotton, if I say this one. So if you crumpled it, many creases can be formed. Many creases can be formed. It requires ironing. So when you wash cotton clothes, it requires regular ironing because they form many creases. Whereas nylon, polyester and other fibers, they are wrinkle free. In whatever the way you crumple them, they do not form creases. Next advantage is synthetic fibers are abrasion resistant. Abrasion resistant. Abrasion means wear and tear. Okay, for example, you have cotton cloth, one of the shirt maybe. So if you wash it again and again, for example, you purchase a new dress or new shirt, so 1, 2, 3, 5, 7 months or a year, gradually the cloth gradually become dull and you have to purchase a new one. Because wear and tear is very high in cotton clothes, silk cloth, woolen cloth. But synthetic fibers are wear and tear resistant. No matter how many times you are using it, it is gradually, means the process of wear and tear in synthetic fibers is quite slow. So it has a long lasting property. So that is called as abrasion resistant. Means so natural fibers, in short you can remember like this, that natural fibers are less durable. It is not so that once the cotton cloth is bought, when the cotton cloth is purchased, so it lasts for years. But yes, you can say same thing for the synthetic fibers, it lasts for the years. Sixth advantage is moth resistant. Means, see, natural fibers are actually organic matter. Are organic matter means they are made from the natural substance of plants or animals. So they are the organic matter, so it is attacked by fungus, attacked by bacteria and other moths. So gradually it is decomposed. Whereas synthetic fibers are made from what? Synthetic fibers are made from petroleum products. So it is totally artificial. It is not organic matter. So it cannot be not attacked by moths. Moths or molds. Molds means fungi. Okay. Seventh advantage is very common. They are lightweight. Synthetic fibers are light in weight, whereas natural fibers are quite heavy. Next is inertness. Synthetic fibers are inert. Inert means non-reactive. It do not get react with any of the gas from the atmosphere. It do not react with water. It do not react with most of the base. So they are non-reactive, so it does not get deformed. It maintain their property for a long time. Synthetic fibers we are talking about. Whereas natural fibers are not inert. They are reactive. They react with the environmental effects and they gradually get deformed. Ninth and the last use given in your textbook is very common, and that is less expensive. I think I have given you these examples in the beginning, but I was not aware that it may be given in your textbook. Yes, it is less expensive. Synthetic fibers are less expensive as compared to natural fibers. So 9 advantages are there. Along with these advantages, we have some disadvantages also. So whenever we discuss about the advantage, we have to keep in mind that there are some disadvantages. So the topic is disadvantages of synthetic fibers. Very less disadvantages are there, but then also we have to keep those things in the mind. First of all, they melt easily on heating, and also they burn easily. Melt and burn easily. So we have to be careful that if we are wearing some synthetic fabric material, and if we are burning firecrackers during the festival, or we are working with such type of factories or furnaces where the temperature is very high, so it is quite usual that this fabric catches fire. They burn easily, and on burning it forms beads. I think you have seen that if some of the plastic material is burnt, some small beads are formed, and these high temperature beads stick with the skin if we are wearing such type of material, and it can harm us. So in short, the synthetic fibers melt and burn easily, so take care while ironing them. Take care while you are burning firecrackers or dealing with such type of hot temperature. Second, they are non-biodegradable. Non-biodegradable material. These are non-biodegradable means we have seen the advantage that they cannot be attacked by moths, so they cannot get decomposed. So once the synthetic fibers, nylon, polyester, etc. is used, and you throw it on the soil, it is not going to get decomposed by bacterial activity or fungus activity. So it remains as it is in the environment for a longer time. Longer means number of years. So they cause soil pollution. If you throw this used material on the soil, it causes water pollution. If you throw them into water, it causes air pollution when you burn them. So it is one of the huge disadvantage, we can say. Third one, they are uncomfortable. In summer season, particularly we are talking about the clothes, that if you wear cloth made from synthetic fibers or the fabric, because they are having low water absorbent property, they do not absorb moisture or they do not absorb sweat of your body. So the sweat is trapped between skin and cloth. Cotton cloth absorb the sweat from your body, so your body become free from sweat. So that sweat comes on the surface of cotton cloth, and that sweat then later on evaporate in the atmosphere. So your sweat gradually throws out of your body, so you become comfortable in the cotton clothes. But in the synthetic fibers are not absorbing sweat, so sweat remains as it is on the skin, and that creates uncomfortability. Last disadvantage is they cause skin problems. Because on the dry atmosphere, static electricity is produced on the cloth, and the continuous sparking can be obtained. These sparks, which are produced on the cloth, can damage the skin, and one of the disease called eczema is also produced. The one of the picture is given to you in your textbook, page number 46. Then eczema produces red colored spots on the body due to continuous sparking. This eczema is produced due to continuous sparking in the dry season, in winter especially. Eczema, the disease in which the red color spots occurred on the skin. Okay. So these are the disadvantages of synthetic fibers. So here is the end of the topic of synthetic fibers. Next topic will be about the plastics, another half of our chapter. Please make notes of all this. Till then, best of luck.